Hello friends, my name is Sumit and I welcome all of you to bispsolutions.com. This is my second video on Salesforce integration with Informatica, and in this video I am going to explain that how can we integrate data between two Salesforce org. Recently I got a requirement from my client that they want to transfer all their data, they want to migrate all the data from one Salesforce org to another, to a new one, and for that they would be looking for a solution which can help for a long which could be help them for a long duration, and the solution which I suggested them, that could be Informatica, because Informatica is a complete ETL tool in that before loading data into a new org we can perform some transformation, we can apply some transformation to that data. So therefore, I decided to share the same solution with all of you. So let's begin. Now, before moving on to this, so the first thing you should have at least two subscription of Salesforce and one Informatica cloud registration, which I have already configured. So as you can see here, I have got an Informatica cloud. So I have already registered and I have been session timed out because I was inactive for more than 30 minutes. So I can click on log into Informatica cloud and I simply logged in into it. So let me log in into my Informatica cloud first. And let me show you the interface, how the interface looks like of Informatica. Now, once you registered on Informatica and you logged in, you would be redirected to either Overview or Task Wizard or Design or Monitor, any one of them. So it's basically when you will be registering first time, you would be redirecting to the Overviews. And in Overview, you need to click on Skip Ahead. So when I click on Skip Ahead, we have Prepare, Contain, Integrate, Run and Monitor, Administrator, and so on. One very important thing which we need to keep in mind, that before moving on to the next step, before setting up connection between two org, you need to download and install the Secure Agent. Basically, Secure Agent is a lightweight program that Informatica Cloud needs to integrate and manage the data. This Secure Agent would be required by Informatica, so this need to be installed mandatory on this system. I have already installed the Secure Agent. And before moving on to that, we need to first start that Secure Agent. So let me start that Secure Agent. So I'll search for that Secure Agent. So once we configure Secure Agent on our desktop, we have Informatica Cloud Secure Agent, and I would be running as administrator. So I run it as an administrator. Yes. Now when I run it as an administrator, it will ask for info, it will give you a window which says the Secure Agent is not running or running. So we can see the status of Secure Agent, because I have already configured this earlier, so it's already running up, and you can see the Secure Agent is already up and running successfully. If you are on any proxy environment, so you need to configure your proxy server information. Anytime if you want to restart the Secure Agent for any configuration, after any configuration or changes, we can click on restart. To stop, we have an option for stop. So the Secure Agent is already running, it's already working perfectly fine, so we are not going to follow that step. We directly move on to connection, and we are going to configure two connections. One connection is the source and another is the target. Source connection is from the source Salesforce org, and the target would be target Salesforce org. So either you can configure connection before synchronizing the data, or we can configure the connection, we can set up connection within synchronizing the data. So we can use the synchronizing data, and we can use the synchronizing task. We can create a new task here. So click on new. If you look at here, the various steps are coming,
at the top, so we have definition, source, target, data filters, field mapping, and schedule. Source would be the source org configuration, target would be the target org definition, data filters, while transferring the data from source to target, if you want to apply any data filters, we can set the data, configure the data filters within this section. This is for mapping the fields from one org to another org. And finally, we can run instantly or we can schedule it for later. So we'll be going to see both the things.
So first of all, I design a name and I write sync data between source and target. And the task operation will be, I would be using upsert, update or insert. So if we have any existing data, it will update, else it will insert the new data. Click on next. Now, when we click on next, it will move on to the source, and in source, it is asking for a connection. So as you can see here,
we don't have any connection configured.
So we don't have any pre-existing connection. So we can click on new to create a new connection. So I'll give a name as source SQL connection. Type will be Salesforce. Now, while we are connecting to Salesforce, we would be requiring the, we need to choose a type. So I choose Informatica Cloud Hosted Agent. That's the same hosted Informatica Cloud Secure Agent. So that's the same. And Salesforce connection type would be standard. So if we select standard, we need to provide the username, password, and security token. So those who all are familiar with Salesforce, they know that security token is mandatory if we are trying to access the Salesforce data out of Salesforce. And to know how to reset security token, you can visit the video, my previous video in which I have explained, which I have mentioned that how to reset the security token. So let me provide the username and password, and then we will go for, then we'll provide the security token as well. So that's the username of my source org, password and security token, and click on test for connecting it, for testing the connection, whether all the details are correct or not. So we got the message that test for this connection was successful, and click on OK. So it will create a new connection and store within connection. And later on, if you want to edit the connection, we can click on edit connection, connections, and we can edit that connection. Then the source type would be single and the source object would be account. So I would like to move my account data from source org to the account object on the target org. So I select account. It will give a data preview and we can display the source field in alphabetical orders or include archived or deleted rows in the source. So if any records we have deleted and moved to recycle bin, it will extract those records as well. So these are the records you can see. We have these other records in my source, and I want to move the same records onto my target org as well. So click on, we can save it and click on next. Now on next step, we need to again select, we need to create a new connection because that is a, sorry for the mistake, I made it source SQL, it would be source Salesforce, but anyway, we need to have a new connection. So I click on new connection and this time I give name as target Salesforce connection. Again, same steps, connect to Salesforce using Informatica Cloud Agent standard, and we need to provide the, we need to provide the target username and password. So my target username is this, password is this, and security token is, so that's my security token. Let's click on test to test the connection. So connection is successful. Click on OK. And again, we need to select the target object. So the target object is account because I want to move the data from the source account, source object, account from the source org to the account object and to the target org. So these are the pre-existing records we have in target org or account object in target org. So we move on to next. Now, in the next step, we can apply data filters. So would you like to include all the 100 rows or process only the first 100 rows, or we can, or any data filters you want to apply? So we can have data filters like from account, we can say where the account account type is specific, account ID is something like this, or and so on. So any filters you want to apply, you can apply. Else, in this case, I'm not going to apply any filters. So I move on to next, click on next, and in next, mapping is very important. So as you can see here, all the mapping has already been done. It's a pre-existing mapping in both the app and both the auth. So you do not need to do mapping, but anything, anytime if you want to do the mapping again, you can clear the mapping, or we can clear the mapping and we can map it manually one by one, like this account ID. You want to map account ID, then we want to map the name. So I map account name with account name. Then we want to map annual revenue with annual revenue. So I want to map annual revenue with annual revenue over here. We map this annual revenue with annual revenue. But in this case, because both the objects are the standard objects we have in Salesforce Auth, so the fields are same. So we can go for auto match, and all the fields will be mapped automatically. And to clear the, and if you want to apply some filters, see, mapping can be cleared by clicking on this option, shipping history. You see the mapping has been removed. And to apply some formula, to apply some functions, we can click on functions and we can apply some additional functions. Functions can be applied for validations. So the validations can be applied. And finally, we click on next and we can schedule it. So there is an option, do not run this task as a schedule. Run this task on schedule so we can specify the schedule when we can schedule it based on the time zone, based on which time zone you want to schedule, and repeat, you want to repeat it for hourly or daily or weekly or on monthly basis. So we can schedule this, or if you want to run this instantly, we click on this first option, do not run this task on our schedule. We want to run it at once. And any email notification will be required. So use the default email notification option for my org that the record has been created. If any notifications are there, if any workflows has been set up, so that notification will be worked on the records which we registered from here. So now if we are talking about the transformation, so transformation can be done in field mapping. So in field mapping, we can add some actions, we can apply some transformations here. Click on next. To run the process now, we can click on save and run, or I can say simple save and close. And we want, okay, so we need to select the environment, definitely Informatica Cloud Host Agent, and we say save and close. So a new task has been added within data synchronization task, but it is not started yet. We can download the mapping XML if it is required. We can delete this task. We can run this task now. We can make a copy of this task, or we can edit this task if it is required. Now let me take you to the connection first, to show you that the two connections we have configured in data synchronization that would be added here, the target SQL and the source SQL and the target Salesforce. So we'll go to data synchronization and we have this task and we can click on run. And as soon as you click on run, your process will start and it will your process will complete and it will migrate the data. It will integrate the data from one org to another org. So let me start this process and we'll see the output. So once the process is completed, it will drop a message that the process has been completed successfully, and now we can check and validate whether the process is completed or not. So now let me logged in into my target org and verify whether the record inserted or not. So I'm on the target org now. That's the org. That's the target org. And let's go and have a look whether record inserted or not. So I click on new this week. And these are the records which has been inserted now. There are 17 records which we inserted now. So these are the same 17 records which has been migrated from, which has been integrated from the first org, from the source org. So that's how we can integrate the data between two Salesforce org by Informatica. So that's all in this video. If you have any queries, you can write to us on www.bisksolutions.com. You can subscribe our YouTube channel for more details about more information on Salesforce and integration. You can connect with us for the customized training as well as for consultant plus job support. Keep watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.